Hi friends, Mickey from Figma here. Today we're going to talk about documenting your design work using measurement and annotation shortcuts in Figma. So let's go. If you want to see the distance between any two objects or an object in its parent container, first select it, then hold down the Option key or the Alt key on Windows. Notice that when I hover over the parent container, I can see its position within there. And then when I select this other object, I can see the distance between those items. Now, if I want to add those measurements to the canvas, I can come down here and choose the measurement tool. The measurement tool shortcut is going to be Shift M. With the measurement tool selected, I can now draw distances between edges and between objects. As I am drawing out these distances, I can see how they are at play. If I press Escape or the V key, I can then go into normal move mode. And I can see that as I am moving these objects, those measurements then update. You can also add in custom measurements. So if I go from top to bottom and I want to identify this as being 100%, I can double click on that and then enter in that value. Let's take a look at this other example. So you can see here, I have all of these measurements already on the canvas. Let's say I want to hide them. I can press Shift Y and you'll notice that the annotations and measurements are now hidden. When I press Shift Y again, they will then become available. Let's say I want to remove some of these annotations while in measurement mode, you can select them and then press Delete. Now, if you want to delete all of the annotations on a selected item, I'm going to go back to the Move tool. You can press the V key, select the object, then right click, scroll all the way down and you'll find the Remove Annotations option. Click that and then all of the annotations on the selected object are then removed. Next, let's talk annotations. You can find the annotation down here. The shortcut key is going to be Y. With the annotation tool, you can select objects and leave notes or identify certain properties. Annotations also accept markdown formatting. If I was to type in two asterisks and say card component, close that out and leave some additional information. This is for the main scrolling gallery. Then you will see that annotation on the canvas for your collaborators. Now let's take a look at other ways this can be helpful. You can document colors. You also have the option to set categories. So I can set the category of colors. Here I can add in a property of the fill. This color fill is currently using a variable. So it's demonstrating that there. I could press return and you can see it highlighted. Let's add in a few more. Let's add in that blue, add it in as our colors, and let's add in another. Now, for colors that aren't using variables, when you click on them and you add the property, you can see the value demonstrated here. Now, that value will change based off of what you currently have selected in the color picker. When I come down here and I change hex to CSS, I can see that RGBA value. Now let's view our annotations. To view your annotations, it's going to be Shift Y. We can now see them all on the canvas. This is also helpful for demonstrating typography. So here you can see the text style, the font, font style, font size, line height, and weight. If you want to add in any of these annotations, press Y, click on an object. You can choose a category. If you want to add your own category, we can choose custom categories. This is where you could type in those values. You can change the color. You can even reorganize them as well. I can set this as the typography category. This is my paragraph text. I can put in P, put in a few asterisks, then add in some of the properties that we want to surface to anybody viewing this so they can more easily figure out how this text is being used without having to go over to the design properties panel. Now, whenever you edit or update any of these values, if I was to edit the size, you will see those values updated here in the annotation. Now, you might also be wondering, why is it helpful to have those categories? You can right click on any annotation, choose filter by, and only view the category that is currently being filtered. So I can see just the color annotations. I can right click and I could say, let's filter by typography. And I will see that the typography annotations. The other ones will still be available. They will just have a bit of progressive disclosure involved. So there you have it. Let me know what you think. And as always, happy designing.